Hi Year 7, this is a short little video all about what you are going to be learning, or you might be learning it already, in dance. So in dance you're going to be looking at a professional work which is called Rooster. In this video I'm going to let you know how this links to your wider learning at school. You're going to learn a little bit about the choreographer, you're going to learn a little bit about the dance work Rooster itself, and you're going to learn about what key skills you'll be looking at in dance during this unit. So let's just recap what we have learned previously, and then let's have a look about what we're going to be learning now and what we will be learning in the future. So what we've learned previously, in the last unit, we had a look at creating a dance using a stimulus, and our stimulus was the environment. So we looked at discovery and exploration of new environments. In this unit, what we're going to be doing is we're going to be learning about the set work Rooster, as I said, which is by a choreographer called Christopher Bruce. And he looks at court dancing and ballet within the work. So that's the key thing that we're going to have a look at. We're looking at style this term. And then in the future, you're going to be learning about how to use characterization in dance. And you'll learn about another choreographer called Matthew Bourne, but that will be next half term. So how will this unit link to your wider learning? This is going to deepen your understanding of dance, because ballet technique underpins all dance and body conditioning that we learn. It's really important. It's a really important style. And court dancing is a style that is used by choreographer Christopher Bruce. So we're going to be able to see in Rooster that there are elements of court dancing. And if you go on to study GCSE and A-level dance, you'll look at Christopher Bruce in a lot of detail. So this is giving you a little bit of a taster, really, into one of the choreographers that you might study. It's going to broaden your learning, because court dancing is an important aspect of social interaction throughout Britain's history, particularly the courts of the medieval royals. And in history at the moment, you are learning about medieval Britain, so you can see how it fits into what you are doing. Ballet is also really interesting, because it originated in the 15th century in Italy during the Renaissance period. So it's a dance that was performed in the courts of Europe, in Italy and France. And its influence on us in Britain is still very much seen today. So you can see how all of what you're learning in dance fits into everything else that you're doing in history as well. As I have just said, style in dance is going to be a key thing that we are going to look at in the unit. So, sense of style. In dance, style means the characteristic way of dancing. So, to have a sense of style is to be able to identify and understand the characteristic way of dancing just by looking at or hearing a description. So, what I would like you to do now, and you're going to need to pause the video for a minute, is to identify what styles of dance you can see by looking at the following images. And why do you think that? So you might be able to say, right, bottom left, I know exactly what that style is, but why? Is it to do with the way the dancer's feet are? Is it to do with different arm positions? So please just pause the video and try that activity now. This is Christopher Bruce. So he is one of Britain's most renowned and respected choreographers. He's been dancing since the 1960s, and he's created so many dance pieces. And he was also artistic director of Rombert Dance Company for quite a long time. So let's have a look at the characteristics of Bruce's style. So his style can be described as eclectic, which means varied, so lots of different styles within his style. His different dances show a mixture of different styles, including classical ballet technique. This is what he originally trained in, so he has that classical ballet training underpinning his works. He also has contemporary movement in there and looks at modern dance techniques such as Graham technique. He has folk dancing within some of his pieces, for example, line dancing. He also has elements of tap and tap sequences, flamenco styles, and everyday gesture and pedestrian movement. So these are some of the key features of Christopher Bruce's style. Please make sure that you've made a note of these characteristics. Okay, now we're going to have a look at a section from Rooster. We're going to have a look at a section called Lady Jane. So Rooster is a celebratory work by Christopher Bruce that celebrates the 60s and it celebrates his youth. So the music from Rooster is by the Rolling Stones, and the Rolling Stones are a really famous English rock band that were formed in the 1960s, at the early 1960s. So you might have heard of the Rolling Stones because, yeah, like I said, they're a really famous English rock band. And yeah, let's have a look at Lady Jane, and I'd like you to have a think about what sort of characteristics of the style that you see within this section.
My sweet Lady Jane, when I see you again, your servant am I, and will humbly remain. Just heed this plea, my love, on bended knees, my love, I pledge myself to Lady Jane. My dear Lady Anne, I've done what I can, I must take my leave, for promised I am. Time has come, my love, I pledge my troth to Lady Jane.
the style in Lady Jane. Make a note of some of these things to add to what you might have seen, and you might have some other ideas as well that you can bring to class. So some of the actions that we see in Lady Jane include bowing, and there's also a curtsy as well. We also see the dancers use circular pathways, hand-to-hand contact. There's a strong sense of musicality, so the dancers really working with the music of the Rolling Stones. You also see the dancers perform in unison as well, so dancing at the same time as each other. And we see turns and pliés, and plié is the balletic word for the bending of the knees. So the reason why this is really important is because although we've said that Rooster is about the 1960s, we also see elements of court dancing within Christopher Bruce's choreography, which links to what you're learning in history about medieval Britain. So I just want you to be aware of that and have a think about what elements of court dancing you can see within the choreography, because that's going to be something that we really explore in our following lessons. Now let's have a look at which skills we will be learning in this unit. So for each unit, the choreography and performance skills will be listed with definitions on Frog. So this is how you find it, and you're just going to spend a bit of time now just having a look at those key skills and making a note of them. So by the end of the unit, you will want to be able to recall all of the definitions off by heart. So what you need to do is log on to Frog, type into the search bar Key Stage 3 Dance Key Skills, click on the Year 7 tab. It should just open within the Year 7 tab anyway, but there's also the chance to go on to Year 8, and you scroll to the unit Rooster. So pause the video and just do that now for me, please, making sure that you're taking in all of the key skills that you will learn during this Rooster unit. Quiz questions. So let's see what you have learnt so far in the video. So questions 1 to 5. Number 1, what is the name of the professional work that we are going to look at? I've said this a few times, so hopefully you can remember this. Question 2, what is the name of the choreographer that we are looking at this term, or next term, depending on when you're looking at this video? Question 3, can you identify a characteristic of his style? Question 4, can you identify the section that we have just looked at in the professional work? What is the name of the section? And question 5, can you identify a key action seen within this section? Okay, so I'm just going to go through the answers. So if you can just check off and tick if you got it right, or correct if you got it wrong. So number 1, we're looking at Rooster. Number 2, the choreographer is called Christopher Bruce. A characteristic of his style, question 3, you could have said it's eclectic or diverse, elements of classical ballet, contemporary, aspects of court dancing, so you could have had any of those. We're looking at the section Lady Jane. Well, we have looked at the section Lady Jane. There are loads of other really brilliant Rooster sections, which are all available to watch on YouTube, actually. So if you've enjoyed having a look at Lady Jane, do have a look at other sections in Rooster. And a key action that we might have seen in Rooster includes a bow, a curtsy. You could also talk about the hand-to-hand contact there as well. And finally, just something to inspire you all. This is practical exam footage from one of our A-level dance students. He's left now and he's actually now studying at the Rombert Dance Company. So, you know, kind of gone full circle and doing what Christopher Bruce did. So he is really, really fantastic. This is a solo that he created and performed as part of his final dance performance, and he got an A star for A level. So do have a look, have a think about the different performance skills that he uses, think about why it's engaging to watch, and hopefully we'll aim for some fantastic performances with your Year 7 dance pieces.
I could not foresee this thing happening to you.